Welcome back to the workshop, everyone. On today's build is going to be AMT's 1966 Ford Fairlane 500 with a 427 V8 in it. It builds up into a stock Fairlane 500. You can decorate it as a drag strip car or a street car, whatever you want to do with it. Got a lot of cool options in the box. Huge decal sheet, so we got some nice stuff to look at. Let's look at all the parts, then I'm going to glue mine up. Now, this will be out later this year. It's not out right now. I will link down in the description where you can get your pre-order on so that when it becomes available, you can get it. Now, some people have been whining, literally whining on other websites. Well, how does he get these early? How does magazines get them? But I can't get it yet. Well, it's very common sense, kiddos. Companies like Round 2 Models, who sent this over, will get a production case of like 12 models. They save some for marketing, they save some for their archives, and they send it out for reviews so that when it's available, you know that you can get it on pre-order and get it open right away when it is available. And that's as simple as it is. So right now, with all the shipping issues, the container that's full of these is probably on its way from China already and just has to make it over here. And then the factory will also send a case out via mail or parcel service to company like Round 2 Models to make sure that everything looks the way it should. And when it does, I get a copy of it, the magazines get a copy of it, and we get to do it on the show. That's how it works. It's nothing nefarious or sneaky or conspiracy. Now, looking at the plastic, which is the most important part, we got a sweet looking engine model on here. Check it out. You can actually see like the lifters in there, the cylinders. Underneath, we got frost plugs. That's cool if you wanted to do a diorama, like they're working on the engine. They've got the intake pulled off and all that stuff. We got beautiful cylinder heads. We got a multi-piece transmission there. Oil pan, belt and pulley, water pump system, distributor. We got a lot of detail in this one. Should make up for a very nice looking 427. I mean, even look at like some of the hoses and stuff there. So, definite model in itself. We've got interior, separate door panels, console. We got our hood, check it out, multi-piece hood. We got seat backs, front bench, and rear seats with the package shelf. So now you know you'll be able to get in there and detail your door panels a lot easier. For you guys that like to super detail and go to shows, that's a definite plus. On this tree, we got the lovely dashboard, steering wheel, radiator mount, firewall, inner fenders, separate inner fenders. Don't see that a lot on kits that I build. Wheel backs, steering linkages, lots of detail in this one. Look at that carburetor. Excellent detail on both of those. Rear springs, differential, suspension arms, it looks like, drive shaft. On this little tree here, we have some very accurate looking exhaust manifolds, nice big fan, the hood scoop, fully formed. That's going to look awesome on there. We got our steelies. Those are cool. Full exhaust system. Two-part. You can navigate it in there. We've got a chassis with suspension molded in, part of the suspension molded in. Beautiful detail underneath. We got brake lines, possible e-brake lines even. Fuel tank, frame rails, interior floor, textured carpet, and the lovely Fairlane body. Sweet looking. Nice mold on the body. I don't see any flash or issues yet. Really well done. Nice panel lines on there. Nice trim around the windows. Makes it easy to work on it, especially for the bare metal foil guys. Nicely done on the shape of the body. Yeah, that's going to look sweet. That should be pretty easy to detail. Let me switch over to this side of the table. We've got a larger clear parts tree, separate windshield and back glass, side lights, headlights, transparent red taillights, always like those, steel axle for the back, got a set of what looks to me like red line tires. No branding that I can see on there. Nice tread pattern. They are hollow, which will make them easier to get over the wheels. Much easier to fit on wheels. Beautiful set of chrome parts. We got some hubcaps, air cleaner, shifter, big old intake on there, valve covers, side trim. Really like when they do the side trim separate piece. Don't have to get out the Molotow pin. Don't have to get out the foil. We got what looks like part of the hood trim, rear bumper, alternator, front bumper and grill. We get to put those headlights in there for a realistic look. So you get a look at everything that's on that nice chrome tree. Well done. And last thing, the decal sheet. Over on this side, we've got gauge clusters, 427 logos, Ford logos, Fairlane 500, all kinds of stock logos. And then we move out, we see drag racing logos, Ford emblems, everything to replicate the box art and even more. Very nice looking. I'm going to get to start gluing mine together. I'll be right back. After putting it together, the kit's got way more detail than I thought it would. I thought being the 66 Fairlane, you know, maybe it was an older style kit with nice details, but not as much. But this thing actually was quite surprising. We'll take a look at the chassis. I mean, we've got everything from the coil springs to the suspension arms to the spindles. If you left the spindles loose and glued everything in, you could pose the steering quite easily on this one. I straightened them both out, locked them in tight. It's got inner fenders that you build up. They key into the firewall. I mean, they really go through and think all this out on this one. It's got a great cross member. It's got a multi-piece rear spring, shocks, and differential, but it all lines up and glues together easily. We've got steering controls, everything, and you can see the fine molding on the front end like that. So really pleased with all the extra detail on there. The firewall's got a huge amount of detail on it for just being a single piece. All that goes in there is the brake cylinder in a little bit when we get that painted up and worked on. But yeah, really nice. You can see I use a black Sharpie to label stuff like the spindles in the front and whatnot, just to make sure that I glue them on the correct sides and don't put anything in the wrong way. I even still manage to make mistakes, but hey, life happens. We got the belt and pulley system glued together. The alternator will go on later. Since it's already chrome, I'll give it a black wash with my favorite Tamiya black wash, and then that will be done. I left the reservoir tank and washer bag as separate pieces so I can prime those and then hand paint them. Got the battery, the radiator hose, and that master cylinder all set up to be painted on their own. The radiator mount, I made sure that the fenders lined up with it. Then I just removed it so I can still get the engine and transmission in a straight shot, and then I can super glue this in place. I glued the horns in place. This will all be black according to the manual anyways, so it doesn't matter if it's a separate piece. We got the dashboard with the pedals glued on. That'll look nice. We got the steering wheel glued together. Nice easy assembly there on that part. I've got the hood scoop glued on. I love how that's a two-part and it's opened up inside. You hear it sucking in low-flying birds as that big 427 goes screaming by, trying to breathe as much air as it can. Got the front seat with its back glued on. You can see it fits together very nice. No issues. Cut off all the other parts for the seats in the package shelf. We can get those painted up as our interior color in one. That 427 is a very beautiful engine. Linkages on the transmission. We've got an oil filter. We've got a fuel pump. Ignition coil. Distributor. Oil filler. Manifolds. Starter on there. Water pump housing. All that. Really, really a nice model. I will hand detail all the little parts. I wanted to make sure they're glued on there solidly. Put the transmission on there. We'll get that painted up separately. That is a nice model. If you wanted to have this car being worked on, sitting that on the side would be outstanding. It's a beautiful 427. Got the wheels glued together. Got the carburetors and the drive shaft. I want to paint all those together and have those ready, and I can put the wheel backs on the wheels. Just make sure that The wheels with the little bumps on the front for the hub are on the front wheels with the large holes. The wheels that are smooth on the back have the little holes for the rear wheels for that steel axle across the back. The exhaust, I'm not going to be using all of the exhaust, but I still will paint it up since it's on the tree like that, and then I'll decide how much of these pipes I will be using on my model, and that kind of gives you a hint at what I'll be doing with it. Got the body. All I did with the body is no actual work, just removed the braces up here and there so the paint will go on evenly. And that's it. Really easy to work on, goes together, zero fit issues. Highly impressed by that engine, really impressed by that engine. Love the steelies, and that hood is a good looking unit. The seats in the interior are gonna look nice. I'm gonna hit the paint booth right now. Time to wrap this beauty up and get it done so it can go hit the strip. There isn't much to do anymore, so I'll just show you what we've all got done. We've got underbody here, just detailed minor. Now remember, I don't build show course factory brand new vehicles. I build stuff that someone's been driving around for at least a little bit. This one, he's now taking it to the track because it's the 427 Fairlane. He's been beating it up a little bit. What I did on the interior will definitely upset the factory perfect folks, and I'm totally okay with that. That console really shouldn't be there, but I spent time decorating it. So what I did was I cut it down to get it to fit in there as if the guy had custom fitted in there himself. He wanted the console in there, he set it up that way, and it looks pretty cool. So I just had to cut it off where that one back section is on there, and it fit beautifully right up against the seat. No fuss, no muss. Got the bench seats in there, got that nice looking dashboard, got the door panels all highlighted and set to go. I saw one that was this whitish color in with the red interior, and I thought it was pretty tight. Under the hood, did some dry brushing, got the battery in, got the red tank in there, got the master cylinder in, and highlighted what I needed to highlight underneath the hood. Got those sweet looking steelies. Now the factory one would have had a set of white wheels with the hubcaps in it, but I want to run the steels on mine, and it's my model, so that's exactly what I'm going to do. Like I say all the time, and I've got the red lines facing out. The body is all set up, got those nice taillights in, got the glass in, got the trim done. The grill will go in lovely right there. The test fit said it fits on fine. No big gaps or anything to worry about, nothing to fight on there. So we're all set, and that grill looks lovely with the headlights glued in with a little bit of Mod Podge like you saw me do on other stuff. Got the hood trim glued on, that little thin chrome piece. Got the hood pins highlighted with a silver Sharpie. We're all set for that. That's just the radiator. That will go on after I get the big block under the hood. The big block will be very hard to fit in if I put that in right now. Radiator hose is left. I cut down the exhaust and blacked out the ends. It's going to come off the engine and dump out right underneath the car. So that's how I'd run mine. I wouldn't be running full exhaust all the way out the back. I'm not worried about taking it on the street, so it doesn't matter. And steel drive shaft all the way out. So we are all set. All I've got to do is put the decals on. All the Fairlane 500 logos, the 427 logos, the trunk logo, and everything on there. I will glue the body molding on. After the body is on, I know the minute I stretch it open, I'm going to pop these right off the side, so I didn't leave them on. I'm not using the hubcaps. We got the rear bumper to put on, and then when I come back, we'll be done. See you in a minute. The big 427 powered 66 Ford Fairlane from AMT is all done. I know you want this kit, so I will link down below where you can get it on pre-order, and when it's released, you can snag your own. It has, I think, one of the most beautiful 427 engine and transmission packages in any model kit that I have built from AMT. It is really nice looking, would make a nice display next to the car. You can even set it up the way they have that valley for the intake and the cylinder heads opened up. You could really make a nice in-progress diorama. Now, I went some ways different than a perfect showroom vehicle. I wanted the bare steel wheels. I wanted the different exhaust on mine, and that is my choice. That's how I did it. I also added that center console that technically shouldn't be there, but a guy custom building a car, doing it on his own, might want to add that. I would want to add that. I think it fit in there beautifully in between those bucket seats like that, so that's why I did it. Very easy model to work on. Very easy to do the trim on the body. The molds are nice and strong. I used a little bit of a darker gray marker to do the door panels so that they stood out on that off-white body. I do like that off-white color, that white Cimarron, or white chiffon, I think it was called, and then that Georgia clay red interior. I saw pictures of a car like this, a Fairlane, with the 427 that had the reddish interior with the off-white body. I thought it looked tough. That one had the white wheels. I wasn't a big fan of those, even though they'd be more perfect for a factory representation, so I went with the chrome, the plain steel wheels with that Rust-Oleum chrome paint. Love the trim on the bottom. Makes my work so much easier to put on there. That interior just pushes together. Those door panels are highly detailed and look wonderful with a little bit of work. How about these decals? They lay down perfectly, no cracking, no splitting. We get all the emblems that we need for the hood, for the trunk, for the fenders, for the front fenders. Everything you need is in there. Dash decals are all done, even though I did mine manually because I like to do them that way. Also, what I changed about mine is I painted the steering wheel black. Should have been like a plasticky, wood grainy type texture on it for a real world car. But since my guy is like the cover box, he's running it down the track, I thought he would have wrapped it with those nice, remember those rubbery grips with the vinyl strap and the vented, the holes in them that you could get at Kmart. I saw them on every Trans Am and older car. That's what I wanted to simulate, like a more grippy wheel. So when he's going down the track, he can correct it, because that 427 torque steering on him all the time, you know, as he zips down the track. So we can look underneath, see how that exhaust looks. See how I just terminated it right behind the doors so he doesn't gas himself out, but it looks nice like that. That's how I'd run it on mine, since it's pretty much just a stripped car that you could possibly drive to the track and back. So that's how I wanted to do it up. And if he wants, he can always bolt on the factory exhaust from those end pipes and work it like that. We thank Round 2 Models for always supporting the channel. Such a great company and amazing things. A lot of big Fords coming from them this year. So if you're a Ford fan, I always love those Redline tires. They got the best tires in the business, in my opinion. So many pad printed options, so many wheel options, all kinds of stuff they're coming out with. And that gorgeous 427, the kit's worth it for that engine alone. Thanks for watching the workshop. Remember, it's just a hobby. Smile, build for you, and I will see all of you at the next review.